Good evening, and welcome to Demystifying the SMA, brought to you by the Prince George's County Planning Department and the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel Sector Plan Team. I'm Sarah Benton, your host this evening, and I'm supervisor of the Long Range Planning Section of the Community Planning Division, and also the project manager for the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel Sector Plan and Sectional Map Amendment, or SMA. As planners, we often get caught up in our work, and we use a lot of planning jargon and lingo that you may not always understand. And it isn't your job to figure it out. It is exactly our job and our passion as planners to explain what we do and help you understand. So tonight we're explaining the sectional map amendment, and doing it in the context of our ongoing effort to create a new sector plan for the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel area. Tonight, we will cover several items, including the context for this presentation, which is the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel Sector Plan. Then we'll discuss zoning, what a sectional map amendment is, how it works, who it affects, and how you can get involved. We'll close out with a few FAQs. All the while, we have team members standing by in the chat to answer any questions you might have during this presentation. Now let's dive in. Let's start by briefly going over the context for tonight's presentation. The Planning Department, in partnership with the cities of Hyattsville, Mount Rainier, and the town of Brentwood, county and state agencies, WMATA, and other local, state, and regional agencies, and you, the residents of this area, began working on a new sector plan for the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel area in fall of 2020. Here you can see the outline of the sector plan area in the regional context. Zooming in, there are three jurisdictions included in the sector plan area: Hyattsville, Brentwood, and Mount Rainier, in addition to portions of unincorporated Prince George's County in the areas of Avondale and Chilham. Remember, Plan 2035, the county's general plan, designated West Hyattsville Metro Station as a local transit center. Local transit centers are defined as smaller scale, mixed-use centers that are well connected by transit. Many of these areas are integrated with an established street grid and offer local serving retail. Let's start with a refresher on what a sector plan is. A sector plan is a public policy document developed with input from the community, stakeholders, elected officials, and other interested parties to create a long-term vision for a specific area of Prince George's County. A sector plan contains the county's policies for growth and preservation for a specific targeted area, as well as strategies that, if implemented, could achieve the plan's vision over the next 20 to 25 years, as well as advance the goals of Plan 2035. If you were at one of our previous meetings, you'll remember us reviewing what a sector plan can and cannot do. A sector plan can contain strategies to support different types of businesses so that they'll want to locate in this area, but it cannot bring a specific business to an area. A sector plan can contain strategies that may make the area more attractive for investment, which could impact property values, but it cannot raise or lower your taxes. A sector plan can guide future development, but it cannot regulate future development. And finally, please note that a sector plan can recommend zoning changes. However, it does not change the zoning of a property. Changes to the county zoning map are done by the county council through a separate process called a sectional map amendment, or SMA, which is the topic of our conversation this evening. All right, hold on. Let's take a time out. What is zoning, you ask? Zoning is the legal power of government to regulate the use of private property for the purpose of protecting public health, safety, and welfare. In Prince George's County, this power is delegated to and exercised by the county council, sitting as the district council. Zoning is how the county controls the physical development of land and the kinds of uses permitted on each individual property. Why do we need such controls, you might ask, and why should we care about zoning? Well, the example I like to use is, would you like a liquor store or an adult video or bookstore located immediately next door to your child's elementary school? I didn't think so. Zoning helps us deal with situations like that. And ultimately, Zoning helps implement the planning vision for a community or area. Therefore, the link between planning and zoning is critical. Each property in the county is located within a zone, for example, a residential zone or a commercial zone, etc. The Prince George's County Zoning Ordinance is part of the county code and describes these various zones, lists the uses permitted in each zone, specifies densities, and sets forth the procedures to change the zones. The ordinance establishes standards for the location of structures, building heights, setbacks, and other area requirements. So now let's get back to that sectional map amendment. Actually, we will be talking about a concurrent sectional map amendment this evening. Concurrent, by the way, means simultaneous or at the same time. The comprehensive rezoning process, also known in Prince George's County as the sectional map amendment or SMA process, allows for changes to a section of the overall county zoning map in order to bring the zoning of properties in conformance with approved county plans and policies. By definition, it's a comprehensive rezoning of one or more properties pursuant to and intended to implement the recommendations of an area master or sector plan. A sectional map amendment may be prepared and reviewed after, or as most commonly occurs, concurrently with an area master or sector plan. So some of you out there might be wondering, why are we doing an SMA if we just did a CMA? So I do want to take a moment to distinguish the CMA from the SMA, another acronym which you might have heard around town the last few years. In 2018, the zoning ordinance was adopted by Council Bill CB 13-2018. The zoning ordinance, or the text of the law, contain the rules that determine what can be built where in Prince George's County and the regulations that govern new development or redevelopment. The Countywide Map Amendment, or CMA, was the second phase of the process for the zoning ordinance, which applied the new zones and the new zoning ordinance to all properties in the county, with the exception of the City of Laurel, which has its own zoning ordinance and zoning map. This geographically applied the new laws to real land or property in Prince George's County. So the CMA was a comprehensive rezoning for the entire county zoning map, as opposed to just for a section of the county. The new zones and zoning map went into effect April 1st of this year. Now let's zoom into this map here, showing the sector plan area for West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel, with its current zoning. Examples of common zoning categories include residential, commercial, industrial, agricultural, or a mix of uses. Our zoning gets more specific than that, and you can see some examples here, like local transit-oriented core in the hot pink, and in yellow you'll see RSF 65, or residential single family 65, and ROS in the dark green for reserved open space. So now, going back to West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. As you all may remember, we've been working towards a plan for the past almost year and a half for this area. We were originally just doing a sector plan and didn't anticipate doing a concurrent sectional map amendment while the CMA or countywide map amendment was underway. However, the CMA correctly didn't provide for the level of detail necessary to evaluate zoning changes on an individual property level basis. The CMA was a technical, non-substantive mapping exercise that replaced old zones with a similar new zone. In other words, not diving into the nitty-gritty details of each property. The CMA didn't make any drastic changes, nor was it a substitute for comprehensive planning and zoning. As a result of our team spending all this time doing outreach, hearing from the community, and doing research and analysis of the sector plan area, we did find that some specific zoning changes beyond what was covered in the CMA are needed to implement a new sector plan in the West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel area. And several properties require a closer look and rezoning as soon as possible to support development consistent with the sector plan vision. So, with that, in January, the County Council initiated a concurrent sectional map amendment, or SMA, to go along with this sector plan. A separate or standalone SMA would have taken more than a year after plan approval, and many stakeholders want near-term action. One of the major steps towards implementation of a plan is through implementing its zoning recommendations, and a concurrent SMA will allow us to do this simultaneously with plan approval and move the needle forward sooner. As you may recall, last fall we shared and discussed with you various future growth scenarios for the sector plan area. The sector plan will make recommendations aligned with the preferred hybrid future growth concept, as illustrated here, that resulted from the feedback received during the growth scenario showcase, focus groups, and stakeholder interviews. The SMA is simply the process that allows us to implement the zoning changes necessary to bring these recommendations and others made in the sector plan to fruition. So how does the SMA work? We, the Prince George's County Planning Department, write a staff draft plan. Simultaneous to that plan, we make zoning recommendations in a proposed SMA. That means that instead of just having a draft sector plan document with a chapter on zoning recommendations, we now put our zoning recommendations directly in a draft legal document in the form of a draft planning board resolution that will accompany the staff draft plan to be used to implement the zoning upon approval. We then release it to the public for review. This includes posting on our website. We typically also place hard copies at area libraries with relevant municipalities and at the planning information counter at the planning department headquarters in Upper Marlboro. You then review and comment on it by submitting testimony, written, verbal, or both, at a joint public hearing. The joint public hearing is between both the County Council and the Planning Board, and you must submit that testimony before the close of public record, which is generally 2 weeks after the hearing. The Planning Board then reviews your testimony and endorses the proposed SMA on the same day that it adopts the plan, possibly with amendments based on the testimony received. The council then reviews it and either approves the plan and SMA together as is, approves them with amendments based on the testimony received, or proposes amendments that are not based on the testimony, which will require a second joint public hearing. After approval by the district council, the full Maryland National Capital Park and Planning Commission will adopt the plan and certify the zoning map. So who does the SMA affect? In short, property owners. The SMA will affect only select properties within the sector plan boundary. Typically, the SMA process results in a change of zoning for just a small number of properties in the subject area, and the majority of properties are left in their current zones. At this point, we can say we anticipate making rezoning recommendations for just less than 5% of land in the sector plan area. That being said, just because your property isn't being recommended for a rezoning doesn't mean you shouldn't care. This is the future of your community, and we encourage you to take an interest. So how will you know if the SMA affects you? The joint public hearing for the staff draft sector plan and proposed SMA will be advertised a minimum of 30 days in advance by publication in a newspaper of general circulation in the county and on the county's website. Mailed notice of the JPH, or joint public hearing, will also be sent 30 days prior to the hearing to all owners of land for which a zoning is proposed, and any municipality lying wholly or in part within or within a mile of the boundaries of the land subject to the plan or amendment, and also to any governed special taxing districts lying wholly or in part within or within a mile of the boundaries of the proposed land subject to the plan or amendment. These notices are legal requirements. Often, as a courtesy, the Prince George's Planning Department will also send letters via U.S. mail to all property owners and premise addresses for properties within the sector plan boundary to notify them about the joint public hearing. We intend to do that for this plan and SMA. So how can you get involved? As mentioned previously, you review and comment on the SMA by submitting testimony, written, verbal, or both, at a joint public hearing. The instructions for doing this will be in all the notices and advertisements, as well as on the county website and our project website. While the record is open, you may submit your comments in writing, or you may sign up to speak at the joint public hearing, or you can do both. Even if you aren't a property owner, or even if you live in this area but your property isn't receiving a rezoning recommendation, you're still welcome to comment on the staff draft sector plan and proposed SMA and be involved in the future of your community. At this time, we're unsure whether this joint public hearing will be in person, virtual, or hybrid. So directions on how to participate will be included in the ads and notices for the hearing. We encourage the public to submit testimony for the joint public hearing, whether it be in support or in opposition. Municipalities also have the opportunity to provide recommendations on any proposed rezonings for property within their boundaries. The Prince George's County Planning Department welcomes and encourages public participation and feedback up until the close of the public record for the joint public hearing. Note that it is the County Council that has the power to approve the plan and authorize changes to the zoning map. So with that, please remember our schedule and pay attention to any notices you might receive. When we release the staff draft plan and proposed SMA for public review in late summer and carry out the joint public hearing in the fall, this is your chance to comment. Well, we've covered an awful lot at this point, and I'm sure you still have some questions. So let's cover a few of our most frequently asked questions now. And note, we'll be online to answer questions via the chat for about half an hour after this broadcast is over. So our first question is, how will I know if my property is recommended for a different zone? Well, again, if your property is recommended for rezoning through this plan and SMA, you'll be notified through US Mail. Maps showing the proposed rezonings, all of them, will also be available on the Planning Department's website. So another question is, does a change in zoning mean I am at risk of losing my property? No, not at all. A sector plan is aspirational and outlines goals and recommendations for the future of a planning area over a long-term 25-year period. Sector plans don't take any ownership away from or impose development mandates on residential property owners. If a property owner wants to redevelop a property after the council approves and adopts a sector plan and the sectional map amendment, such a redevelopment would need to be consistent with the recommendations of the new sector plan and would be regulated by the new zoning. What are the immediate implications of any zoning changes to a property as a result of this plan? Well, if the plan process recommends rezoning, that will happen at the very end of the plan through a legal update to the zoning map as discussed tonight. Rezoning can sometimes have property value implications. And note, nothing will change overnight. Even if a property is rezoned, nothing can physically happen to the property unless an owner or their representative initiates a change, for example, through sale or redevelopment. Keep in mind that sector plans only produce recommendations for the future. No change can occur to a privately owned property unless initiated by the owner. So with that, I really want to thank you for joining us tonight and encourage you to check out our website for updates, email us with questions, or check out the county's new zoning via our online atlas at pgatlas.com. With that, thank you and have a great evening.